Dornay kind of burst onto the scene last year as a true freshman. You feel like maybe you're going to have a target on your back this year from opposing defenses?
Absolutely. I mean, that's what it comes with the season like last year. But I mean, it's a different challenge, playing challenges. So, I mean, I expect to have fun with it.
Say teams are going to kick you?
I'm not sure. Your guess is just as good as mine.
Daniel Davey was in here earlier. He was talking a lot about how you guys kind of went one-on-one quite a bit throughout the summer. What was that like, and how did you guys challenge each other?
Daniel's a different type of player. He's a kind of linky kind of guy, so I'm probably going to see those type of players. So I mean, he's helped me with how to defeat a more patient kind of DB or sometimes a more aggressive DB. And he's a lot faster. So, I mean, just push each other. I mean, we've had fun with it, a little trash talking here and there. But, I mean, he knows what he's doing. He's excelled at the collegiate level. So, I mean, it was just really pushing me to be better, honestly.
And what has Keith Williams brought out of you? Some NFL receivers have been back here working out with him as well. Yeah. What type of coach has he been, and what's he brought out of you?
He's been an exciting coach. His technique speaks for itself. He's taught me how to be a better receiver, getting in and out of breaks, seeing defenses on the fly, and I mean, just being all around, light out, not just with specialist, and just being more confident in that role.
Did you get to spend some time with those NFL receivers that were here, like Greg Jones?
A little bit. I got to talk to them about how the coaches and everything, certain things that need them, and how do they prepare themselves for the season and everything, and just how do they see certain things and how to attack certain different kinds of defensive backs, their rotation, if they're more aggressive, and just how to handle them.
How much were you able to grow with Tommy over the summer, just kind of working out, throwing the ball around and all that?
I mean, a lot more. I mean, there were seven times where we were throwing. Sometimes he would just call me up and me and Jordan would get out there throwing. So I mean, I think our chemistry has grew a lot more since last year.
Morning. A lot of the guys have said Brandon Riley is maybe being like a breakout guy on offense. What makes Brandon Riley so good and special?
I mean, he's quick. I mean, people don't think he's as fast as M.A. looks, but I mean, he's one of the fastest guy on the team, and he'll sneak up on you. I mean, his technique is really well. I mean, he goes up and gets the ball. He's not afraid of anything, and he'll blow by you real quick.
The catch in the summer that kind of went viral on social media. Did that surprise you, or that all that happened out of that?
I mean, it surprised me a little bit. Honestly, I didn't think anything of it. I was back at home just working out a little bit. And next thing I know, it's everywhere on the internet.
Who was that poor kid that
old teammate. He played on my high school team my senior year and everything. So, I mean, he was just getting some workout. We were getting a little work in, and he's got the bad end of it.
When you're on a phone with that, I mean, I don't know. Did you post it, or did
No, I didn't post it. I didn't think anything of it. Another old high school teammate posted it, and I don't know where it went viral at. It just blew up, and he kind of like called me to let me know what happened, because I wasn't paying attention.
How would you characterize yourself as where have you improved the most, let's say, since the end of the calendar year to now?
Being more comfortable on the collegiate level, understanding wide out plays, transitioning, route running, seeing defenses, and just going up after the ball and not letting it sit back and come to you, really just being more aggressive with catching the ball and everything.
Scale of 1 to 10, where were your confidence at last year?
At this point, it was a 10. I mean, I know my ability.
You've always been a 10?
I've always been a 10. I know my ability. I'm not afraid of anything.
Even at the receiver position, even though you're still relatively young.
I mean, yeah, but like I said, I know my ability. I didn't second guess that at one point in time, period. Sometimes I'll make mistakes, but that would happen. But I mean, I knew if I get the ball in my hands, I could make something happen with it.
Did you use like the Minnesota game those days, or the experience, you know, with the fumbles and the key moments there? Obviously, you made the play, but maybe you tried a little too hard to do more than you could in that situation.
I've talked to players, I've talked to coaches about it and everything. like I said, I couldn't just call the ball and down and secure the possession on the field. Like you said, it was a learning experience. If I got put back in that position again, I know now what to do in games like that and times like that. So, I mean, it was just a learning experience. It's another tool in my toolbox that I keep in the back of my head that I know how to put in that situation again. I know what to do.
Hey, DeMorne, the passing tree, the routes, the terminology, all that, how is that different for you, I guess, from previous? And, I mean, do you like the passing scheme?
The passing scheme is a lot different from what we ran last year. More, I guess you could say, kind of like NFL type of passing scheme. And I actually like it. It's different. And I mean, those routes are at the next level. So, I mean, if you practice them now, understand them now, get them now, I mean, if I'm talented enough, I can get to the next level and kind of do the same thing there.
Has the coaching staff talked to you with you about how many touches? Obviously, punt return, but the fly sweep or jet sweep, whatever you guys call it, and the passing limit. Have they talked to you about how they want to utilize you on offense with all of that?
They have not talked about touches, but they have kind of talked to me about how they would want to use me and how they see things going on and everything. Coach Riley mentions Brandon Cooks a lot and his work ethic and kind of how they used him a lot. And just kind of like, I guess you could say, the similar type of way that they used him. And just really, just, I mean, it depends on how hard I work for it, really. They're not going to just give it to me after I earn it.
What do you expect out of Terrell Newby at that running back position? He's a guy who's kind of stayed patient while he was in the spotlight, and now it seems like it's maybe his turn to break out a little bit.
I think he's going to open a lot of people's eyes. He's shifty, he's quick, he's strong. I mean, he's similar to what Amir did and everything, but just in his own style. I think he's going to do a great job at the running back spot, and I really think he's going to turn a lot of people's heads.
I know you focus on what you're doing, but did you see him flash a little bit in spring? Coaches, they spoke pretty highly of him. Did you see him
in practice, you've seen it. I mean, he would make juke moves, or he would pick up blocks in practice that helped the quarterback make certain throws differently. So, I mean, he really did his job. And I mean, you would see him run by you a couple times. I'm blocking, and you just see the you just hear the one behind you and everything. You know, in his team running. So, I mean, I think he's going to turn a lot of heads.
Hey, DeMorne, we talked to some fans outside, and they said you're the autograph they want more than any other player. Can you talk about the fans, what it tonight means?
I mean, it's all about them, really. I mean, I give it back to them. We have the best fans in college football. I mean, I absolutely love them. I mean, they're with